Welcome to part 5 of your online physical geography course. So part 5 really introduces the values and the activities involved within plate tectonics. As we can see, it covers units 13, 14, and 15 of the text, which is surface plate tectonics, subsurface tectonic force, and then also surface volcanoes. So we're really going to be learning a lot about the dynamics of our planet, the fact that we are constantly in motion, the fact that our plates on average are moving at the same rate in which your fingernails grow, about 1 inch or 2.54 centimeters every year. Doesn't sound like a whole lot, but if you think about it, if all of our plates are moving at the same rate in which your fingernails are growing, within the average human lifetime, entire continents can move up to 6 feet. Well, think about generations. Maybe there's 3 or 4 generations of your family. That means these continents were probably 24 to 36 or plus feet away from where they are today. So how do we know that? Well, we know that first we have GPS units around the world plotting and triangulating the location in which continents and land masses are and which direction they're transferring. We also know because of Alfred Wegener, as you'll learn about, who in 1912 proposed the theory of plate tectonics. Theories are not just ideas. They're scientifically proven ideas that move forward with the evidence to understand the dynamics of our planet. He was a meteorologist up in the Greenland area who began noticing that as large pieces of ice were calving off, the size of small states were then floating in the ocean, that only made sense that, wait a minute, can't our continents move as well? Which would make sense. That being said, if our continents and land masses are moving, they must move of one of three ways. They must either move as a convergent piece, where they are moving together. They must diverge, where there are areas that they move apart. Or lastly, they can be what we call conservative zones or transform boundaries, where they strike and slip one another. So they don't actually make or destroy anything. They just slide back and forth. Lucky for us, we have one of the world's most sought-after transform boundary, the San Andreas Fault. What's interesting about our history and being along the western coast is that we obviously are on the line of both the North American and the Pacific Plate, but there actually used to be a plate that was in between them called the Farallon Plate. That Farallon Plate completely subducted underneath the North American Plate, which made most of our mountain ranges, specifically the Sierra Nevada. Well, fast forward to more present times, we are still bits and pieces of that Farallon Plate, but now our two boundaries are meeting. And when we talk about these boundaries, we also have to identify that there are two types of material that we're looking at. We're looking at continental crust. We're also looking at oceanic crust. Oceanic is where the oceans are, and it's usually denser and made more out of basalt. Then we have continental plates, which are usually lighter and made predominantly out of granite. Then you move forward into, surface tectonic force, which I just mentioned, and then we wrap up with surface volcanoes. We learn that there are two families, many different types of volcanoes, but two families. We have constructive and destructive. Constructive make new places, so it usually runs and flows more like maple syrup or honey. Then we have destructive volcanoes, which are more explosive, things such as, maybe Yellowstone. We actually have some destructive volcanoes that are now extinct, but in California, when you think about everything over on the eastern side of the Sierra, closer to Mammoth Mountain, Mono Lake is the crater, the caldera of the center of a supervolcano that had, at one point, the magnitude equivalent to what was at Yellowstone. We still do see activity. We see hot springs, geothermal hot springs, and we can also still measure motion. So, even though we don't have any formal active volcanoes in California, that doesn't mean we're out of the water yet. We still do see some tremendous activity in the Mammoth area. And who knows, within our lifetime, it is possible to see a volcanic eruption in California again. The most recent eruption in California was a little less than 700 years ago. That's very, it's almost a blink of an eye geologically when looking at that time scale. This week we have, again, a discussion reading quiz, and you have 2 extra credit activities. I am expecting you to memorize the plates in which make up our planet. Again, we have continental and oceanic, and what makes it really easy is the name of the plate has to do with what's on the plate. So you have the Pacific plate because you're the Pacific Ocean. You have the North American plate because it's got North America on it. Except for us, we're technically, if you, living where we are now, most of us live in California along the Pacific plate, unless you pass over the San Andreas Fault, which is kind of interesting. Anyway, enjoy, and we'll talk soon.